Well, I live in Corona, which is in Goa, and I am a 12th science student. I passed my 12th science with 80% in PCM and 80% in overall, and I joined because of my uncle. My uncle is a chief engineer in one of the companies, so he advised me, and he has been advising me since I was quite small, and he has been telling me I've been here, and also that's why I also got I got into it, because the places he has told me I liked, I wanted to travel basically, and this is the best way to travel.
I am basically from Ajmer, Rajasthan. I did my pre-sea training from Kanyakumari. I did 4 years of BE in Marine Engineering. And before that, in 12th, I got PCM 65% and aggregate of 76%. So that's what my education background is, and that's how many marks I got. Very adventurous sort of option that I got really interested into it when I heard about Merchant Navy. When people told me that this is how your life is, you travel a lot and you have like to work on odd hours, it's not a 9-to-5, it's not a normal 9-to-5 job. So it attracted me.
Your background?
I live in Mumbai, in Jogeshwari. After 10th, I scored 80%. Then I wanted to become an engineer. So there was two options, like go for diploma or after 12th degree. So I was scared because in 12th, I have to take science, and I don't know. I was scared because if I took science, I will not score that much marks. So after electrical field, because there was only three options left for me, that is chemical plus chemical engineering, civil engineering, and electrical. And I thought the much interesting was electrical, so I took electrical engineering. Then after diploma, I went to degree. And once you did the diploma, you will join direct second year of the degree. So I done 3 years of degree, and I scored good job, like I can earn very fast. So I was looking, then one of my friends suggested that the Merchant Navy is a good field to earn money fast. So I went to Merchant Navy. So for Merchant Navy, then I researched on internet how I can go to Merchant Navy. So there was one option, that is ETO course. Only one option is there. Any other way, you can't go any other way in Merchant Navy. So you have to do this ETO course, that is Electro Technical Officer. We can do this course before sponsorship only, but you have to select the college that has a campus interview. So if you select the college which don't give any job, then there is a loss of money, then you will struggle to find the job. So before joining the institute, you must research on that institute. So I researched many institute, then I found Great Eastern Institute. So I joined, that was very near from my house, that is, it's in Lonavala, Pune. So I joined Great Eastern, and I did that course is 4 months course, and its fees is around 4 lakh. So for 4 months, 4 lakh. So I did that course before exam only. Companies came for the campus interview, and I got selected in one company, and I got the job before I pass out the.
Yes, I'm pretty happy because, well, now I'm just a cadet, but not so much responsibility. But after that, I'll be earning a lot of money and quite a bit of responsibility. Basically, I'm missing being around most of the time. Like if I need to be around in an emergency, I cannot be there. But then that's a compromise, because when I'm there at home, I'm there 100%. While many of my friends, they're there, but actually they're not there, because they go to college. Once they come home, most of them are tired, and then they're exhausted. They cannot play. They cannot have spent time. While I'm there, when I'm there, I'm totally at home only. So I can get up in the morning, enjoy my full day, then at night I can go to sleep. I can spend time with my family.
I am really, really happy with my decision. The only thing I'm best on board is my mom, and everything else is like, it's replaceable. Everything you are missing here, you have something else, like to fill that gap basically. It's not like you're getting bored here. You have a lot of work to do, or you have got many things like you can to easily entertain yourself. You don't have free time at all.
I am happy because what was my goal? To earn money fast. So I am earning now. My salary is around 2 lakhs. So that is big money. So I am happy because I earn money very, very fast, and I can spend like I want. So I am very happy. I miss my family. Everybody does. So me too.
Well, the right procedure to join would be, I've done a DNS, which is a Diploma in Nautical Science. It leads to a...
But did you do after sponsorship or before sponsorship?
I had taken the sponsorship, then I joined it. So basically, you do your 12th. Well, I would suggest the right procedure would be, complete your 12th, answer your boards, because many the questions they ask you for the interviews and they ask you the questions, they are from your 12th Senate syllabus only, PCM, Physics, Chemistry, Maths. They'll ask you basic principle, basic formulas. They'll give you a few problems, they tell you to solve it, and they will tell you to explain a few principles. So that will help you a lot. Whereas if you do it before, you may not know those principles, those derivations, those problems. You may not know how to solve. So it's better if you do it after your 12th.
There's not one right procedure, but the one thing you must do is take sponsorship before you join your pre-C training. That's a must thing. I have a YouTube channel. That's what I tell in my videos. That was the basic reason I started making videos, that people didn't know whether to take sponsorship or not. They thought like normal engineering, you get placements after your course. But in Merchant Navy, you have to take sponsorship before joining a course, before choosing a course even. So that's the only thing I would recommend, but I will not suggest people to join as a junior engineer right now, because the market is flooded with candidates. It's not like you are passing from an institute and companies are standing in line to give you a job. It's really tough, it's a hard struggle, it's a harsh environment. Only if you are really, really passionate about being a marine engineer, you should come as a junior engineer, otherwise please don't.
To right procedure to join Merchant Navy, I already said there is only one way to join the Merchant Navy after electrical engineering. Yeah, I forgot to tell you, to come in this field, you can do electrical engineering, electronics engineering, EXTC, that is electronic and telecommunication, and also instrumentation. So out of that four field, you can come and join the electrotechnical course, and you can come as a electrical officer on board.
It was not very difficult because I did it after my 12th, after I answered my boards. I have done it in Anglo-Eastern, and there we had two interviews. So he was asking, what is Bernoulli's principle, what is Archimedes' principle, how does the ship navigate, how does the ship maneuver, then how does it get propelled forward, and then how will it stop immediately, and basic questions he was asking. Well, as Puneet Malhotra was asking me questions on my personality, like what do I like to do, he was checking my personality basically. He was checking my general knowledge. That's it.
Very tough. It was very tough. Usually they will ask you about physics, a lot of physics. There's a lot of questions from physics, and they focus on alternators, induction motors. Then there's chemistry about batteries and basic electricity. Then there's about magnetism and maths, normal maths and aptitude questions.
As I am an engineer, so in four year of engineering, we already run all the electrical engineering subjects. So that interview is all depend on the basics of electrical engineering. So if you have studied in engineering very well, then you can answer very easily. So basic questions they are asking, like what is induction motor, what is DC motor, types of motor, what is mega test, then the very most important, before coming to this field, you must know the reading the circuit diagram. A circuit diagram doesn't mean that what you did in practical in college. The circuit diagram means like control system, a PLC control diagram, or there is automation, like automation system control diagram. You must know that circuit diagram, how to read the circuit diagram. So before joining ship, before coming to this field only, you must prepare for that.
My normal routine at sea is from 4 to 12, so 4 in the morning till 12.
Can you explain what you do, like 4 to 12,
from,
then watch?
From 4 to 8 I have a watch with chief officer.
So what do you do during the watch?
Well, during the watch, you basically keep a lookout and you check if there are any vessels, what is the if there are any vessels nearby, what is the situation that is being developing. Then if there are no vessels, then maybe you'll do some a bit of like paperwork, but in which you can when immediately when you require to maintain attention, you can keep a proper lookout. Then from 8 to 8:30 I have my breakfast. Then 8:30 I go either paperwork or deck work, depends on what you also gives me. So if I have mostly my deck work on this ship is basically stencils and light deck work, not too much. And paperwork is of filing any month end or weekly. I have to file it. And then I get an off from 12 to 4. Then again at 4 in the evening, I have a watch from 4 to 8. That's the evening watch. I keep it same way with chief also only. And then after that, I'm off from evening from 8 to next morning 4. And it's the same routine while at sea. And while at port, it is from 6 to 12. I keep a watch with the third officer. So I keep 6 to 12 in the morning and 6 to 12 in the evening. I'm on a tanker at present. So if we are loading, we will check the if we are loading, we'll check the IG pressure that is maintained in the tank. Then we'll check what pressure, whether there's any pressure at the manifold. Then we'll check the ballast, whether we are we have to check the stresses. Then whether we have to take how much ballast we have to remove at what stages we are in. Well, in paperwork, I'm his right hand.
Okay.
And deck work, there are other people who is his right hand.
Okay. At sea, the first thing I do is I wake up at 7 a.m. From 7 to 7:30, I get like freshen up, take bath and stuff. At 7:30, I have my breakfast. And after that, I proceed to the engine room. At 8, we start working, or we start toolbox meeting first and then we go for work. And at around 12, we come for lunch. Before that, we have a tea break at from 10 to 10:30. And then at 12, we have lunch, 12 to 1. At 1, we go back to the engine room. And then till around 5:30, we come back from the engine room. Then I go for a light workout. And then I have my dinner. Then I come back, play some TT or play PlayStation or talk to people, like socialize in general, and then go back to sleep, and it repeats the cycle. Port, it gets really hectic because you have to keep 6 on, 6 off watches, or 5 on, 7 off, 7 on, 5 off watches. So usually you are working 12 hours a day and your sleep schedule gets slightly disturbed. So it's a little hectic on port, but the change is always good. And I have to take care of purifiers and compressors basically, and then there's bunkering, internal transfers and small routine jobs in the engine room like other engineers do, that's all.
Being an electrical officer is very good, and we have little more advantage than the other engineers because we don't have watches. So we just need to do 8 to 5 like 8 to 5 duty. So 8 hours we need to work, and except that, if we have any emergency, then we have to work.
Yes, I get enough rest. I get maybe about 12 to 14 hours of rest. And while I get on off on Sunday, and while we depart from port, so on Sunday I just keep the 4 to 8 watches, which has to be kept. Well, there's no exception for that. Since you're a watch keeper, you have to keep a watch.
Yes.
And well, there's no other extra work on your off days. That's on Sunday and after you depart your port.
Yes, usually you get enough rest, but there is nothing, there's no backup on ship. That's why we are getting paid so much. So if there's an emergency, you have to go no matter what. Whether it's Sunday, it's a Sunday night, it's a Saturday night, or it's like 3 a.m. in the night, or it's noontime, 12. It doesn't matter what time it is, you have to go if it's an emergency. But usually you get Sundays off, Saturdays half days. It's a very good life. It's not like you're working 24/7. It's good.
Yeah, we get enough.
My duration of this contract that I got is 4 months. Yes, I'm pretty happy with the wages and facilities. Because at present, for what I do, I feel this is enough for me.
The duration of my contract is 6 months, 6 plus minus 1 month, to be precise. And I can't say I'm really happy with the wages, but it's okay. My wages are $1,500 per month, and I'm okay with it. Though I was expecting a lot more than this.
6 months contract in some company, and in some company they are giving a 4 month contract also. So 4 month four on, 3 off, like this. So around the year salary, and some companies are giving a 6 months contract, and only that period you will get salary. Yeah, I am happy. I already said my salary. So I am happy with my salary.
Me, I'll spend my free time maybe watching movies and listening to music and spending time with the crew members who are there. I spend time with while they are having their dinner and all, I sit with them. And well, the other options available on board are table tennis, watching movies with the others. Then there are many many games also. Then there are books to read. There's a gym, which now is being developed after a long time. It's being developed.
I spend most of my free time talking to people and watching movies. I love movies and series. And then there's I play PlayStation a lot. And then there's TT. Basically, I do everything available on board. There's table tennis, there's gym, there's PlayStation. You can watch movies, you can listen to music and stuff, you can talk to people, you can play cards with the crew. So that's, I do everything.
There are plenty of options on ship to spend your time. Like, you can watch movies, plenty series are available on ship. You can take from anybody. Then usually all people coming in, we have two recreation room. Like everybody spend their time by sitting there, by watching movie or playing games. Like some ship have carom, chess, table tennis, or we have gym also. So we can spend time there.
I'm pretty excited in the beginning when we get a notification about 1 month before that you have been aligned for Swan's ship and your approximate date of joining, a tentative date of joining. So I'm pretty excited that time. I start preparing if I have any work as a work ashore, if I have to get any paperwork done, I get it done. Then I start saying goodbye to my family, that I'll tell them that I'll be going for so and so time, and I'll be coming after so and so time. Then I start packing. Then a few days before going, maybe about 3-4 days, I start feeling a bit sad because it's hard to say goodbye sometimes. So I feel a bit sad. But and maybe about 1 week on board, once I join, maybe a week, I'm a bit homesick. But after that, I get used to it.
Joining is the toughest part of your contract. When you're coming on board, you're slightly nervous, a little excited, and very sad because you're leaving your family behind. So, and you know, it's the time when you know you're going to be away from your family for 6 long months. After that, as the days pass, you get closer and closer to your sign off, so it becomes slightly okay, and you also adjust to the onboard routine. But the beginning is really, really hard. I don't really prepare much. My mom does all the packing for me, so not much. But yeah, I have to meet everyone. Otherwise, the whole contract, you'll get calls. Tu milke bhi nahi gaya, tu milke bhi nahi gaya. It's really, really irritating.
Before joining ship, first of all, I go to my doctor. I visit my doctor and take whatever medicine I want. Like, in case of emergency, I don't want to. In case of emergency, I can use that medicine. That's why I'm going to doctor. Then, of course, I will buy my personal things like clothes or any grooming kit, everything. Of course, very sad. but there are confused feeling, because after vacation, my money is already finished. So I wanted to join ship, but I'm leaving my family here. So I'm feeling sad also.
Well, I'm really excited to sign off because after a long time you're going home, you get to see your family, you get to spend time with your friends, so you're pretty excited. And finally the work is over. You can rest for about at least 1-2 months, you can rest with no work, just relax at home. So I'm pretty excited before signing off. Just about a month before I start counting the days, okay, so many days are left, so many days are left. I start counting back the days. And this time I'm even more excited because this time I'll be completing my sea time and my contract on the same date. So I'll have to start counting. I'll be really excited. And the preparation that I do, basically my paperwork, my DLP, that is distance learning program, is completed. Then I can start putting my finishing touches on my projects and taking signatures of the chief officer and whichever the officers I require. Then I start packing. I pack a lot of chocolates for my girlfriends, for my friends, and for my families. Then I buy a few. When I go ashore about a month before, if I go to any tourist port, I buy some souvenirs, small souvenirs.
The sign off is really, really, really exciting part. It's the best day. It's the best day of your contract. So I get really excited on sign off. So forget about the preparations. Whatever I can see, I'll put it in my bag and I'll just like, I'll take off as soon as possible. I don't prepare. I don't do anything else. It's about handing over.
Yeah, signing off day is very... I can't explain that day because that is the happiest day of all, you can say, happiest day of life. So preparation for sign off, yeah, you have to CDC from captain, so you should check your CDC that he put stamp and date is correct and signing off code. Yeah, that's all that you must check. That
first thing that I do after sign off is one day sleep. I plan, I'll sleep. This is my third ship. I've signed off twice. I always planned I'll sleep for a full day, but I don't manage to sleep a full day.
Yeah, because you're so excited.
So once I go home, I sleep for maybe 2 or 3 hours, then I get up because of jet lag. Mostly it's jet lag. So I get up and then after that I spend time, I talk to my family. My dad wants to catch up on me, what I've done, how was my time on board. He asks me questions and I tell him, then I catch up with him. How was his time? How did he spend those months? And then I meet up with my friends, my family. Then the first very evening I go with to my friend's house. I spend time with them. We go roaming, we go gallivanting, we go to eat, spend time basically.
First thing I do after sign off is take my bike for a ride.
And what bike do you have?
CBR 250. I love going on rides, and that's one thing you cannot do on board. I know it's not going to start after 6 months, so I tell my friends to take it for a spin occasionally, so it works fine.
I will meet my girlfriend.
Does she come to receive you?
Of course. She will come to receive.
Yeah, because
we can go to the engineer side also. Engineer side means to become a marine engineer. So after, but in India that course is not started yet. So in New Zealand, they started that course. So you after becoming electrical officer, you can give fourth engineer's exam, and you can become a fourth engineer, and then so on.
All right, well, and it was pleasure talking to you. All the best for your second mates exam, and we hope that you clear everything in first shot.
Yes, thank you.
Thank you. It was good talking to you. All the best, and we hope that you get your promotions very quick.
Thank you. Thank you so much. I'm trying for it.
Okay. Good. It took only 10 minutes. Okay, Bhatti Sab, electrical officer. Thank you very much, and I hope for the best.
Okay.
And I hope you get to meet your girlfriend very soon.
Thank you, sir. Bye.
I hope she comes.
Subscribe to Ship Sailor Sunil. I am really honored to sail with a fellow YouTuber. Please subscribe to his channel, Ship Sailor Sunil, and also subscribe to my channel, The Merchant Navy Guru.